Big news in the AI world. Stability AI just released a long-awaited new Stable Diffusion model, Stable Diffusion XL 0.9, a leap forward in AI image generation. At this end of this video, I compare the just released model with previous one Stable Diffusion 2.1 and provide you with a way to do it by yourself. For now, I wanted to say that the resulting photos are damn good, and even with simple prompts, the level is comparable with Midjourney. For those who don't know what Stable Diffusion is, Stable Diffusion is a deep learning text-to-image model, released in 2022. It's primarily used to generate detailed images, conditioned on text descriptions. Let's break it down to the main changes. The new model has one of the largest parameter counts of any open-source image models, boasting 3.5 billion parameters base model and 6.6 billion parameters model ensemble pipeline. Parameters count is a sum of all weights and biases in the neural network that the model is trained on. The new model creates realistic imagery with a greater depth with a high resolution, 1024 by 1024, which is 4 times larger than the version 1.5 and 2 times than 2.1. Good news, as the new model still can run on consumer GPUs, nearly only Windows 10 or 11 or Linux operating system, with 16 gigs of RAM and NVIDIA GeForce RTX 20 graphics card equipped with a minimum of 8 gigs of VRAM. Linux users are also able to use a compatible AMD card with a 16 gigs of RAM. SDXL series also offer a range of functionalities that extend beyond basic text prompting. These include image-to-image prompting, imputing a one image to get variation of that image, inpainting, reconstructing missing part of the image, and outpainting, constructing a seamless extension of an existing image. So basically, Stability AI aims to provide users with a feature already available through user extension, such as ContourNet. Personally, I find this to be very good news, as it will lower the entry barrier for working with Stable Diffusion. So let's talk about availability. Stable Diffusion XL is now available on the Clipdrop by Stability AI platform. Stability AI API and Android Studio customers will be able to access the model 26 June, as well as other leading image generator tools like Netcafe. Stable Diffusion XL will be provided for research purposes only during a limited period of time to collect feedback and fully refine the model before a general open release. The code to run it will be publicly available on GitHub. SDXL 0.9 will be followed by the full open release, SDXL 1.0, targeted for mid-July. As we said before, let's compare previous version Stable Diffusion 2.1 with a new one, Stable Diffusion XL. First of all, I think you already know with the previous version of Stable Diffusion. Price of price out of the left. And to be honest, I don't know how to compare them, because there is too much difference. Important to know that in a Clipdrop version, available version of Stable Diffusion XL, there is no ability to write negative prompt. As you can see, there is way more higher resolution, a lot of details, as you can see. That's actually stunning results, despite it's just ordinary prompt, only one prompt without negative prompt, as I said before. There is, as you can see on the left, not so impressive, and I don't know what to say. So let's have a look on the next one. So, and this is the next one. Once again, there is too much difference between them, and it's really hard to compare. But as you can see in the first image on the right, it looks way more natural. I do like this shallow depth of field on the background, though unfortunately this is not so impressive on the left. Especially these quite strange looking blue eyes, which definitely looks not so natural. I do like these hairs, it looks very natural, especially with this background. But there is some strange skin artifacts. That skin looks old for some reason, but it looks way more better than the picture on the left. I saw that previous one was hard to compare, but this one way more harder, because what you can see on the left, something not so cool. But picture on the right looks really, really nice, because it has very shallow depth of field, once again the same effect as the previous one. Also, this picture extremely sharp, it looks like high quality 3D render. So the next one, very interesting and very important and also very sad. You already know that previous version of Stable Diffusion has serious problem with the hands, and now we still have such problems. It looks way more better than the left one and way more natural, especially if we will see some fine-tuned model. I suppose that it might completely solve the problem with the hands, at least partially solve the problem, as it's already been done with the previous version of Stable Diffusion. I do like this one because, to my mind, obviously there is a lot of difference in resolution, but not too much catastrophic difference in quality, because it looks quite similar in terms of style and, I would say, even in terms of colors. But on the right, you can see the same effect as the previous one. That's very shallow depth of field effect, which allows to the model hide possible artifact, and to my mind it had been done purposely, because we generated only 5 images and we saw the same effect already 3 times. So yes, I think it's been done on purposely. But thanks for that, our pictures look way more cooler and way more flawlessly, which I do like. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching and write your comments, ideas about the video, and you will list Stable Diffusion in the section down below.